For question number 11, numerical answer is 3. And through the steps of solution, in step number 1, let us take down the data given in the question. Diameter of the wire, that is D, is equal to 0.5 millimeter, that is 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter in SI unit. We are also given Young's modulus for steel, Y is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 11 Newton per meter square. The length of the wire, that is L, is equal to 1.0 meter. The extra load to be put at a later stage, its mass small m, is equal to 1.2 kg. We are also given rounded off values of free fall acceleration, that is G is equal to 10 meter per second square, and a value of pi rounded off, that is 3.2. We shall make use of them at the right time. In step number 2, recalling definition of Young's modulus for a solid, Y is equal to longitudinal stress by longitudinal strength in symbol, that is sigma n for normal by epsilon n. Now longitudinal stress is the force applied by cross-sectional area A of the wire, and longitudinal strain is extension in length delta L by the original length L. It's giving me F into L divided by A into delta L. Since looking for extension here, we can write next delta L is equal to F into L divided by A into Y. Putting numerical data next from this list, we can write down that delta L is equal to, now what is the force? That is the force of gravity on this extra load, that is mg. This is 1.2 kg into the value of free fall acceleration, that is 10 meter per second square. This much in square brackets, giving me the force applied responsible for extension. L, the original length, that is 1.0 meter. Next cross-sectional area, that is pi d square by 4. Just confirm this. So cross-sectional area is pi into the value of d, 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, that is squared, divided by 4. Once again, in square brackets, we have got the cross-sectional area, A of the wire, and Young's modulus Y, that is 2 into 10 to the power 11 Newton per meter square. Calculation shows the value of delta L is coming out to be 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, that is same as 0.3 millimeter. That is step number 2. Well, the question asks which vernier scale division coincides with the main scale division, and for that, in step number 3, we recall the formula already mentioned in the hint, that is least count of a vernier is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. Now 1 main scale division is the least count of the main scale already mentioned in the question to be 1.0 millimeter. And since 10 vernier scale divisions correspond to 9 main scale divisions, 1 vernier scale division must be 9 upon 10 times main scale division, that is 1.0 millimeter, is coming out to be 1.0 millimeter minus 0.9 millimeter, and that is 0.1 millimeter. This is the least count of vernier scale. And another formula already mentioned, extension of the wear is the least count of vernier into coinciding vernier scale division. Extension of wear already found here to be 0.3 millimeter. So this quantity already calculated 0.3 millimeter. Least count of vernier found just now 0.1 millimeter. Therefore, the vernier scale division, which corresponds to, coincides with a main scale division, that must be 3. This must be 3, and that is the answer of the question already mentioned here.